गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल होप एंड लर्न। मैं अमित कुमार प्रधान होप एंड लर्न के इस यूट्यूब चैनल पर आज इंडियन पॉलिटी का सीरीज स्टार्ट कर रहा हूँ। इसीलिए अगर आप लोगों ने हमारा चैनल सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब कर लें और साथ ही साथ बगल में रेड बटन भी दबा लें ताकि आने वाले हर वीडियोज की नोटिफिकेशन आपको मिल जाएगी। अगर हमारा ये वीडियो आपको अच्छा लगे तो लाइक और कमेंट जरूर दें और अपने दोस्तों में शेयर करें। और होप एंड लर्न के इस यूट्यूब चैनल में मेरे बहुत ही काबिल दोस्त पंकज जी मैथ का क्लास ले रहे हैं। अगर आप लोगों ने उनका वीडियो आज तक नहीं देखा है तो जरूर उनका वीडियो देखें और लाइक और शेयर जरूर करें। मेरा ये जो इंडियन पॉलिटी का सीरीज है ये आपको आने वाले हर एग्जाम के लिए फायदेमंद साबित होगा, चाहे वो स्टेट लेवल की SSC हो, स्टेट लेवल पब्लिक सर्विस कमीशन हो, सेंट्रल SSC हो या किसी इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट के नॉन टेक्निकल पार्ट का एग्जाम हो, इस सब के लिए आपको फायदेमंद साबित होगा। तो लेट्स विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी मोर टाइम विल प्रोसीड टू आवर फर्स्ट एपिसोड ऑफ इंडियन पॉलिटी जो कि है कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडिया वी हैव सम एक्ट्स ऑफ हिस्ट्री, मींस रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट 1773, पीस इंडिया एक्ट 1784, चार्टर एक्ट 1793, 1813, 1833, 1853, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट 1858, इंडियन काउंसिल एक्ट 1861, 1892, 1909 एंड गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट 1919 एंड 1935। ऑल दीज एक्ट्स आर इम्पोर्टेंट इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एक्सेप्ट दीज फोर एक्ट्स व्हिच आई हैव पुट क्रॉस मार्क। These acts are important from the history point of view, but not important in the constitutional development. So let's start. चलिए शुरुआत करते हैं। Regulating Act 1773. ये act जो है, it put the foundation of central administration in India. Secondly, here, though central administration was founded, Governor of Bengal will now designated as Governor General of Bengal. Most important point. That's why Warren Hastings become the first Governor General of Bengal. And thirdly, Supreme Court was established in Calcutta in the year 1774. Remember this year is very important. Generally question was asked on which year Supreme Court is established in Calcutta. So we have to write 1774. Secondly, we will move to Peace India Act. This act took place in 1784. Remember this year, 1784. This is very important. And moreover, in this act, company territory in India means जो territory company का under था that will now called as British possession of India. Secondly, there will be dual government means there will be separate court of directors for political and commercial. So dual government and diet both are different thing that I will explain to you later. मैं आपको बाद में समझाऊंगा लेकिन फिलहाल के लिए don't get confused on dual government and diet. Third is your Charter Act 1833. Under this, there is a centralization of British India. These two are different. It is the foundation of central administration. This is the centralization of British India. That's why here Governor General of Bengal will now called as Governor General of India due to the centralization. And that's why William Bentinck become the first Governor General of India. And Governor General of Bengal, Governor General of India, both are different. And in this, there will be open competition for selecting civil servants. But this competition is only for the British nationals. And last was that East India Company, which was earlier both commercial and administrative body, and now remain only administrative body. Now we will move to our next act, is your Charter Act 1853. So under this Charter Act 1853, as you know that in Charter Act 1833, civil service exam is only for the British national. But here, civil service exam is now open for Indian national also. 1853. Civil service exam now open for Indian national. Generally question comes as objective. And thirdly, secondly was what is there? There was the representation of the Indian in legislative. representation of India in legislative. The most vital point is under this act is separation of legislative and executive. This is the very vital point. Separation of legislative and executive. So these three are the important point of the Charter Act 1853. Now we will move to Government of India Act 1858. As you know that Sipahi Revolt took place in the year 1857. After these disturbances, Queen of England made this act, that is Government of India Act 1858. So, according to this act, now Governor General of India will be known as Viceroy. Governor General of India will now be Viceroy of India. Will now Viceroy of India. Similarly, Lord Canning become the first Viceroy of India. So, Lord Canning become the first Viceroy of India. So, don't get confused between the Governor General of Bengal, Governor General of India and Viceroy of India. In this, the system of dual government abolished. That means there is no separate board of directors for political and economic affairs. So, in this system of dual government, abolished. Isko band kar diya gaya. And thirdly, this act is known as the Act of Good Government of India. Is act ko kehte hain Act of Good Government in India. Many people think that when question comes, which act is known as Act of Good Government of India, many people write Government of India Act 1935. No, it's Government of India Act 1858. Then, Office of Secretary was created under this. So, these four points are important in Government of India Act 1858. Now we will move to Indian Council Act 1909. Indian Council Act 1909. This act is also known as Morne Minto Reforms. This act ko Morne मिंटो रिफॉर्म्स भी कहा जाता है. इट्स कॉल्ड एज मॉर्ले मिंटो रिफॉर्म्स. सो इन दिस एक्ट द साइज ऑफ लेजिस्लेटिव काउंसिल, साइज ऑफ लेजिस्लेटिव काउंसिल इंक्रीज फ्रॉम 16 टू. And secondly, it was the first time that Indians were allowed in the Executive Council of Viceroy. In this, Indians are allowed in Executive Council of Viceroy. Remember, this is very much important point. Indians are allowed in the Executive Council of Viceroy. Generally, question comes, who is the first Indian in the Executive Council of Viceroy? Your answer will be Satyendra Prasad Sinha. He is the first Indian. Satyendra Prasad Sinha. In this, another important system has been introduced. That is, system of communal representation. Communal representation means Muslim voters will now choose the Muslim rulers. In the communal representation, Muslim voters were to be elected by the Muslim rulers. Now that's why Lord Minto at that time was the viceroy and Morley was the secretary. So Lord Minto is known as father of communalism. Generally question come, which viceroy is known as father of communalism? It will be Lord Minto. So you get all these points. You have a screenshot or you have a diary to write down. Next we will move to Government of India Act 1919. So like Indian Council Act, you know, is known as Morley Minto Reform. That's why Government of India Act 1935 is known as Montagu Chelmsford Act. Chelmsford was the viceroy at that time and Montagu was the secretary. So in this there was a system of dynasty was introduced. System of dynasty in province. Remember, system of dynasty was introduced in province only, because that means provincial subject, there will be two subjects. One is your transport subject and another one will be the reserve subject. Transport subject means those subjects which are be decided by the governor with the help of minister, while reserve subjects are those subjects which are only be with the governor. He doesn't need to consult minister for the approval. So this, after introduction of diarchy, there is an another important point of bicameralism. And third is your direct elections. So what is bicameralism? Bicameralism means there will be two courts, like lower courts, upper courts. That we are having now Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, or in some states we have two types of courts. That is called as bicameralism. And direct elections will be there for the selection of the member to this upper house as well as lower house. Then third and another important point is the communalism, which was earlier limited to Muslim, will now extended to Sikh, Anglo-Indian and Indian Christian. So communalism will now be the extended. Then Office of High Commissioner established. It's a very vital point. Office of High Commissioner established at London. So this point and this one, these are very much vital. In Government of India Act 1919. Okay. Now we will move to final act, which is known as your Government of India Act 1935. So this is the lengthiest of all acts. जितने सारे act हैं, ये सबसे लंबा act है. And here we have three lists. That means one is your provincial list, another is federal list, another is concurrent. These three lists, because under this Act of Government of India Act 1935, there is a separation of power between center and state. So there is a power of separation between center and states. That's why provincial list, federal list and concurrent list was established. We will have that means provincial list is for the province, federal list is for the center and concurrent there is a mix of both provincial and federal. So it is your federal is a 59 subjects, provincial is 54 and concurrent is your 37. Two more important point is that RBI was established under this act and federal court was established under this act. These two are very vital point of the Government of India Act 1935. And the last feature is that DIRC, which was earlier introduced in provinces, was abolished in provinces. But introduced in center. Remember, it was abolished in provinces but introduced in center. Don't get confused. So that's why we have a detailed discussion of all these acts. Now, if you have any doubt, you can go to the comment box and any objective you can ask me. Or agar aapne video acha laga, to jarur like kare, doston mein share kare. Aur aane wale नेक्स्ट वीडियो में हम दोबारा चलेंगे मेकिंग ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के बारे में. तब तक अपना ध्यान रखिए, कोरोना है तो घर में रहिए, सुरक्षित रहिए, पढ़ाई भी जारी रखिए क्योंकि बहुत सारे एग्जाम का अभी न्यू ओपनिंग्स आने वाला है. और हाँ, जो जो एग्जाम्स निकल रहे हैं उनकी जानकारी भी आपको 4.1 के इस यूट्यूब चैनल में दे दिया जाएगा. तो इसलिए आप जरूर इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और साथ ही साथ बेल आइकन को दबाएं. सो टेक केयर, गुड नाइट.